Hello there, my name is Dr. Carlo Ojeda, emergency medicine physician. With edexitvideo.com, this channel, The ED Exit Video, and the website, The ED Exit Video. I'm just announcing that I'm going to start a whole new series of videos called The Golden Nuggets of Wisdom. And I'm going to eventually create a playlist to have them all there. Essentially, they're going to be small, short videos about a simple question and answer. Facts and things that you should know if you ever plan on practicing some kind of emergency medicine, whether it be as a student during rotations, as a mid-level practitioner, nurse practitioner, or physician assistant, you're a paramedic, you're a physician assistant, a tech, a nurse, whatever. Most of these facts, even if you don't practice emergency medicine, will be applicable to an urgent care center, to a family practice, or to any other professional who just wants to keep their knowledge up and their factoids appropriate and keep sharp in terms of medical knowledge. I think you're going to learn a lot by watching this video, and I'm certainly going to learn a lot by preparing them and having this discussion and refreshing my mind on all these things I should have known from medical school, and I'll keep up gathering data and so on. The video is going to consist of a simple question that's going to have a specific answer. Questions that either will be relevant to your clinical practice or that you will be asked by colleagues, by attending physicians, supervising physicians, and so on. In medical school and residency, there's something called pimping, where you're asked questions or a series of questions until you can't answer anymore. Sometimes to ridicule you, sometimes to show you how little you know, but most of the time because we want to know how much you know before we start blabbering about simple things. If you can't answer a whole bunch of questions in a row, you know a lot, and then we can start with the more difficult stuff and teach you about more relevant stuff. If you stumble for the first two questions that are simple, then we need to go basic or not do it at all and say, you got to go back home and study. So you'll have a question, a small pause, and then I'll give you the answer, and then a little discussion about the answer. Let's start with a very simple question. What is a fever? Well, simply put, a fever is a temperature of 38 degrees or 100.4 Fahrenheit. That's the answer. There's nothing more to it.
So a little bit of change of scenery here. So fever, just because it's not 100.4, doesn't mean I'm not going to work him up. Obviously, it depends on the clinical picture. So 100.2 fever, probably the same work. If they look clinically ill, they're going to get blood work, they're going to get an x-ray if they're coughing, etc. But if they look well, I'm not going to do anything differently except kids. Remember, kids less than 2 months old, some people push it even to 3 months with a fever. You got to work them up. Now, there's different variants of how, the degree of the workup for the sepsis in kids, but the bottom line is if they had a fever or parents thought they had a fever, there's plenty of documentation showing that parents are very good in telling who has a fever or not. So even if they don't have a documented fever, if they said they had a fever, they probably did, and I work them up just the same. Now, the fever here was 100.0, and they look well, and they're not vomiting, they're keeping fluids down. I'm not going to admit them for that, but if their parents felt a fever and they look kind of ill, I'm going to admit them. I'm going to do septic workup, chest x-ray, blood work, dose of ceftriaxone, etc. So what is a fever? 100.4 degrees or more. I hope you like this small, up-to-the-minute clinical nugget. And I will see you the next time. Bye.